games now, just leave it up to the player, and they can do the mental preparation, and they can come out. They know they have to be ready. They know they have to have an edge when they arrive. So it's really up to the players to make sure that they're on for the game.
There go the dignitaries being introduced to the two teams. What a game this is going to turn out to be, Saber. What are your bets? Any score predictions?
I don't want to make any prediction, Sudarshana, but Candy, like I said at the start, they are without a doubt favorite, especially in this ground. But having said that, Navy has all the possibility, all the skill, all the X factors and the match winners in their squad to do anything different. But I like to see some impact coming in the second half, especially from the under 19 players who toured for Malaysia, especially those science duo, Tanuja Madhuranga and Sajid Silva. Supun Dilshan, in fact, who's already starting this game. I like to see him running, especially he's taking his senior college player, Rishad Dharmapal, on his opposite side.
It'll be a good battle between the two brothers last time around. Richie Dharmapala, the young older brother, came up on top, scoring a try as well, whereas Richard Dharmapala was bundled into touch almost thrice. So this time around, he will be looking for change fortunes.
Look, we know that our Navy have got a really strong defence. They've shown it all year, and I'd imagine that's what they're going to bring to this game as well. In the last game, Richard Dharmapala really had nowhere to go. They had his number, and they made sure they took care of him all day. Well, I'll just wonder what the coaching staff and what the Candy team will have. They would have prepared now for this game, for this rushing defence. The defence from Navy will be coming all the time. So now they'll have something in their pocket. They'll have a little secret. They'll have something where they can come back, and they'll be able to work around the defence somehow. I'm not sure how, but we'll find out soon.
Also, do keep in mind, from the last team, this time around, Fasil Marija is in. We know what an impact he can bring. Fasil Marija only had about 10 minutes in the previous game to add in, and he did try and make a difference as well, but that's what we were speaking about, the Candy team.
So there, young viewers, if you're watching and you're seeing those players go in there, you notice how they fly off their feet. So in rugby, you very rarely see a player making a tackle where they leave their feet and fly off, because then once you leave the ground, you can't generate any power off the ground, and then you lose all your power. So young players watching, what you want to do is you want to impact with your shoulder, and then you want leg drive. So you don't want to actually be leaving your feet like those players were doing there.
Everything is set here, and Thilina Vijayasinghe will be taking the kickoff. Two Thilinas at the back of both lines, Sabir. Two 15s, two kickers, both from Candy, but one playing for Navy. Who do you think will have the most effect today?
Well, of course, Thilina Vijayasinghe, you can't forget him, the highest point scorer in the last year's Dialogue Rugby League. So he's also a man in form. Chandimal, on the other hand, also controlled the game nicely when he needs. He's also a man who can use the uprights. But Candy, on the other hand, Thilina Vijayasinghe has been brilliant this season so far. Here's the start from Thilina Vijayasinghe. Veerasinghe, rather. Shehan Lema Patirana just missed the ball, and Candy straight away playing advantage. Good tackle coming by Lee Keagle. Fazil Marija with his first touch, sending out wide.
As Candy continues to play, Danish Karanta sends it out. Richard Dharmapala has space. We know he has the speed. Puts in a little chip. Good pressure coming in from Candy. Brilliant work done. Thilina Vijayasinghe does very well to save that one. Now Tanaka Chandimal with the reply kick. Thilina Vijayasinghe is down. And Candy is looking to run. Vijayasinghe going through the middle. Still on the move. Has support from his forwards. Veeratna now gives it out to his brother Gayan Veeratna. Held up by Gertha, Danushka Gertha Pereira. He has some fond memories in these grounds. Kanuku Disanayaka goes crashing in for Candy. Referee playing advantage for Candy. Penalty advantage coming in Candy way. Referee decides no advantage. Line offside, not moving away from the ruck, says the referee. We'll take a look at the replay.
Yeah, that's right. If the replay comes up, you'll see that I think it was Richie Dharmapala make the tackle, and then he just got caught behind the advantage line, and He was just in the way a little bit. Interesting that they're not taking a pot shot at goal. You see, he's just caught in the wrong position. He's trying to get onside. He never actually retired back onside at all, did he? So Candy decided to take the kick for the line. So they're going to put the pressure on. They've got a throw in. They're probably 10 metres out from the try line. So there's a lot of pressure coming Navy's way now.
While we were taking a look at their replay, Candy opting to go for the line, and they're making their intent clear. They have the momentum on their side. Earlier on in the game, they want to put points on the board. Damit Disanayake with the throw-in now. Very safe to Patirana. The ball is available at the back, but very good pressure coming in from Navy. Candy has to regroup now. They do that very well, and on the move, Candy. How far can they go? Veeratna now to Maricha. Gives it out to Dimitri. To Richard Dharmapala. Danush Karanjan. A little bit of a fumble by Tilna Vijay Singha. And gives the chance to Chanaka Chandimal, who kicks the ball, doesn't find touch. We've had a few balls that were kicked that did not find touch. Veeratna now kicks it out to Richie Dharmapala.
Hurry back!
Will it be second time lucky? No, it goes to Tilna Veerasinghe now. Veerasinghe with the kick. Inside the 22, not collected cleanly by Nivanka Prasad. In trouble, in a lot of trouble here. Candy turned the ball over and they have knock-on advantage. Dimitri goes cashing in. Inches away. Can they get the ball out? Yes, they do. Gayan Veeratna straightens it up. Damit Veerasinghe. Damit Disanayake actually. Candy still with possession. They have numbers on the outside. They need quick ball out, Candy. Veerasinghe now to Veeratna. Gives it to Dharmapala. Dharmapala to Danush Karanjan. Can Ranjan go all the way? Yes, he does. And a little swan dive. First point scored. Candy Sports Club. How about that? A little bit late, Paul, but finally they did send it out. They could have done it very much easier. But Candy ultimately scores and gets good use of their possession.
Yeah, that's right. Look, the original bus came because Richard Dharmapala came from the other side and made the initial bus. But here we have the replay, and it's the end of it. Navy were defending very narrowly, and they left a lot of space on the outside for Ranjan. You give him space and you give him time on the outside, he's always going to score a try.
Well, Paul, he's starting where he left from the CR game. A hat-trick of tries last week in Longdon Place. Sri Lanka's sevens captain, Danush Karanjan, with the 13 shirt on. He's scoring the first try, but all due to the bad decision-making from Nivanka Prasad, the army number 8. He got the ball. He had so much time in space. He should have kicked it out, or he should have sent Tilna Vijayasinghe before he thinks make his late decision.
It was a terrible play there by that player. He actually waited. He waited until the defence came up, and they came up right up on top of him, and then he made the pass, put his other player under pressure. They lost the ball. There's a little knock on there. I thought Navy did really well. They came back out of the defence and they had put a lot of pressure on, but they just defended really narrowly, and that's why on the outside there was a lot of space there for Ranjan.
Absolutely. So Tilna is not successful with his first kick, so 5 points to nil. Take a look at that beautiful picture. Danush Karanjan, there was no stopping him there. Little bit of a swan dive and he scores. Beautiful pictures. Brought to you from www.thepapari.com, on Dialog TV and also on My TV as well. As Navy kickstart the proceedings again, go straight to Bhuvaneko Dangamu. Candy straight away looking to play an expansive game. Veeratna takes a quick tap and goes in. Veeratna is through. Needs support. Arrives in the form of Fazil Maricha. Referee playing advantage again. They have numbers on the outside. Ball going out wide. Danush Karanjan. Ranjan still on the march. And loses the ball out. Ranjan maybe could have cut back in and looked for support, but decided to go on his own.
Well, he did have a man on the outside of him, Richard Dharmapala. Dharmabala actually gave the pass to him for him to score a try. Maybe he might have wanted to return the favour there. He just needed to come inside, run at the inside shoulder of the defending player, just try to drift in a little bit, create a little bit more space, draw and pass, and Dharmabala would have been away for a try as well.
Credit to skipper Roshan Veeratne. He just took the ample time to think that decision, the penalty decision taken quickly, and look at Candy. They made almost 45 metres into the opposite territory.
It was interesting though, during those that phase of play, there were two opportunities there for penalties. Both of them were for holding on to the player, so the tackle player is getting tackled. The man who's making the tackle is not rolling away, he's not releasing. So the opportunity is not coming there for the attacking team to play. So there were two advantages there in that last passage.
8 minutes into this game, this game is playing at a feverish pace and penalised yet again. Navy need to get back on their discipline. They were a very disciplined side so far this season, but they've already given away four penalties. How difficult and how costly is this going to be, Sabir?
Well, Sudarshan and Nivanka Prasad, the Navy number 8, he's not having his best of time for the last 8 minutes. Look at this, he was isolated from that number 8 break. Early on, he made the poor judgment on the decision making, which cost the try also.
Well, I don't think that was his fault, actually. He came across, he had three players on him. He sort of made a little bit of space. Lee Kegel was the one that was there to clean, he was meant to clean out. He just got ahead of his player. He needed to come back and to make sure he came in through the gate. So it was him. He was the player who was there, who was meant to do cleaning out. He wasn't able to clean out. He went to ground. And then that gave Fazal the opportunity to get in over the top and jackal.
So Telina's second time lucky and adds three more points. And just like that, 8 minutes into the game, Candy with an 8-point lead.
It's absolutely electrifying atmosphere here at Nitola Ground, Sudarshana Paul. It's absolutely electrifying atmosphere. And the crowd is screaming out. 8 points to nil, but Navy, I'm sure they are a better team than this. So far, it's all Candy.
Well, I think Navy's just been a little bit inaccurate. There's dancing in the commentary box, and there's a little bit of dance music downstairs. But really, the crowd's gotten behind Candy here as they receive the kick.
Buane Kodangamo with his second receive from the kickoff. Has it under control. Now Demetri gets the ball at the back of that mall. Roshan Veeratne now gives it out to Vishwamitra Jayasinghe. Jayasinghe in space. With all the talk of Navy's defense being solid, they've really faltered this game so far. Richard Dharmapala, one and on. He's finally brought down. And Yakub Ali transfers the ball to Soiru Anthony, who goes down the middle. Little bit of a fumble there. Unlucky.
So what I'm seeing in the defensive line from Navy is they're not working hard enough to cover up the holes. The gaps are just a little bit too wide. And I think that's because Candy are pushing the ball so wide. They're really spreading the defense out and they're struggling to link up.
It's not the first time that we saw Fazil Marja and Danush Karanjan sending two long passes to Rishad Dharmapala. So after every two build up from the forwards, they're getting their numbers out wide and they're getting space as well, Paul.
Well, what's happening is they're creating, they're getting go forward and they're going past the gain line around the ruck, and that's causing the defence to crunch in, and that's giving the space on the outside.
Here we go, Rishi Dharmapala. It's position wise, Candy 80% maybe. And Rishi Dharmapala, the scrum half. Here's Nivanka Prasad, breaks now, sends out a long pass to Lee Kegel. That's a bit high by Gayan Veeratne. Clearly referee playing advantage now. Here's Richard Dharmapala once again trying to use his box kick. And Thilina Vijayasinghe controls nicely, but the referee calls back for the initial high tackle by Gayan Veeratne.
So that was just a little bit high, and it just went up. I wonder if we'll see the replay of this, and here you'll see the tackle. Didn't actually look like it made contact with his head, but the referee just thought it was a little bit too high. Minimum is a penalty, and that's what he got. Maximum, though, is, of course, a red card.
So he did not consider that as a dangerous tackle, but maybe accidental. That's what he considered that as. A little too high, says the referee. So, interestingly enough, Navy going for points. There's no reason why they shouldn't try this out. We've had a very safe kicker in Telina for Navy.
Well, I don't. It's not just that. What they want to do is they want to take some of the steam out of the Candy team. At the moment, they're sailing very quickly, that Candy team, and they've got a lot of momentum. So they just want to slow the game down a little bit, take some of the momentum away from Candy. Lines up this kick. It might be maybe 55, 57 meters. It's a long kick. It's got the legs. It's a beautiful kick. 3 points on his own side of halfway, and he nudges that through, and he still had another couple of meters to go. So that's a danger sign there for Candy. So any infringement or any misdemeanor in your own half, and that's 3 points.
This is the question you asked me, Sudarshan, before Telina. Vijay Singh and Veera Singh, we are complicating his name because both the fullbacks are Telina. But Navy fullback Telina Weerasinghe, the last year's highest point scorer, nailed that 54-meter penalty, which is a good sign for Navy. So it's 8-3. Here's Richie Dharmapala sending out to that man again. And luckily, it's play on. Supun Dilshan, it's come with a touch, but unfortunately, Navy off it on this occasion, I think.
The contest off it.
Going off the feet was the call by the referee. So there you go, Richie Dharmapala collecting it and giving it out to Telina Vijay Singh, and good charge in by Soiru Anthony.
Yeah, that was great pressure from his blind side there. But here I see the tackle is being made, and it didn't look like he released the ball. Now he releases the tackler, and the referee's saying that he just came in and sealed the ball off. And there he goes off his feet, but I thought that was a bit of a harsh call.
Little bit of a harsh call. Going Candy way. The crowd doesn't complain. Damit Weerasinghe now, and Candy set it up. The ball's at the back of that mall. Navy not committing many numbers because they know of the threat that Candy possesses at the back of the line. Veeratna now to Marija, gives it to Dimitri. Vishwamitra joining the line. Dips into that tackle. Very judgmental these days with the new laws coming in. Navy turns it over.
On your hand.
Losing the footing, says the referee. So, Candy now with a chance to get that 3 points back.
So the referee there is saying that when there's a contest, when there's player versus player, and we're going for the ball, he says hands just go on the ground, and he's saying that's going off your feet. So if you go off your feet, you're out of the contest, you've got to roll away. So that player there, he went off his feet and then came back and came for the ball.
With the back line on your side?
And that's illegal.
Experienced Danushka Pereira also asking the referee for some clarification. Here's Telina Vijay Singh now. Right on the 22-meter mark. And he puts another 3 points for Candy. So Candy moving with 11-3.
So 3 more points, 11-3. This has been a crack-a-lacking first 10 minutes of the game.
That's right, it's end-to-end action, isn't it? If you want a cup of tea, I'd wait till half-time to go and put the kettle on, because it's going to continue like this at a frenetic pace.
Navy with the restart. Bounces in no man's land. And Lee Keagle now with the ball. Has been held up. Keagle still held up. Finally brings himself down, needs to release. Candy need to release now. Navy has managed to recycle that ball. Sajit Saranga goes in now. Good bit of work by Saranga. Navy first time in Candy's half and threatening. Lahiru Herat goes into contact. Richie Dharmapala now gives it out to Chanaka Chantima. Carson De Silva goes into contact. Navy, can they finish this off? It's very important they get the try now. Nivanka Prasad, big numbers. They opt to change sides again. Roshan Ranasinghe, the skipper, taking the ball in to contact. Richie Dharmapala has options on both sides. Chanaka Chandimal gives it out to Lahiru Herat. Herat tackled. Lee Keagle attacks the gap right next to that ruck. Candy rushing up and Kasun De Silva goes in with the ball. Shahan Patilma contesting, but good clearance work by Dulanjani Vijayasinghe. Lovely run coming in by Chanaka Chandimal. Have they managed to turn the ball over, Candy? No, Navy still with position. Richie Dharmapala gives it to Chanaka Chandimal. Just 5 meters away, Navy. Need support, Chandimal. A tackle going in there. Navy penalized again. This is the sixth penalty that's gone against them. They need to get their penalty count right, otherwise they're going to be in deep trouble, Sabir.
Red had numbers blue in the side.
All their efforts in vain. So much, look at that skill set, awareness about Chanaka Chandimal, but what's the decision? Referee says coming sideways. I'm not really didn't get the correct view on that replay.
So the referee was saying that red had numbers there at that breakdown, and they the blue were coming in from the side. So at the present, Navy, their discipline's really hurting them. So any opportunity, if they're going to try and build some pressure, they can't let the pressure go by giving away a penalty.
Just like the doctor ordered, they are now playing according to their strength. This is what they were doing so much in the warm-ups comparing to the opposite team, Candy. We saw Candy did lots of set pieces in the warm-ups, whereas Navy doing the faces, how to work the faces. But we saw last couple of faces, it's almost, I think, continuity with 10 faces maybe.
Absolutely, that's where the strength lies for Navy Sports Club. They're absolutely critical when it comes to their set plays. Damit Veerasinghe now sends it out to Soiru Anthony, and Paul was querying why they weren't using Soiru Anthony. So there you go, Paul, you have your answer. They might have heard us. And Roshan Viradna with the kick from the base. Very good strength shown there, two tackles broken. But referee, this time letting Candy go with the hands on the ground.
Oh, good play!
Kick deep, Roshan Viradna collects it inside the 22 but decides to go. Good kick onto the side, Richard Dharmapala is chasing but a little bit overcooked maybe. But Roshan gets a good distance for his team.
I like the recognition of space there you saw from Roshan. You saw him take the ball, he looked up, he scanned the field, he pointed where the space was, telling the chasers that's where he's going to put the kick. Unfortunately, the accuracy from the kick wasn't quite there. If he got a little bit more height and put in that same area, he might have given his winger an opportunity to get through on the ball.
But what a good collection by Supun Dilshan, the Navy winger. He just overcame Gayan Veeratna's chase and he beat another tackle, and then the third man, he got caught. Superb stuff by Roshan Veeratna.
And also the tactical and the technical analysis of the Club Rugby League will be brought to you by my co-host Sabir Kader on the Back to the Board segment as Navy get their ball out from the set piece. Good tackle coming in on this Navy skipper. Candy have been defending quite well. This Navy outfit, Dulanjana now with the ball. We know what he can do. 7 tries he scored so far in this season. 8 tries, I'm sorry. Chandimal now has options. Roshan Ranasinghe tackled on his tracks by Yakub Ali and also Chatura. Chandimal now gives it out to Herat. Here at Tilna Vijayasinghe throws it out to his number 14, Supun Dilshan. Chandimal acting half back now, gives it to Richie Dharmapala. Big hit coming in on Satya Ranatunga. Chandimal decides enough is enough and he puts the ball to boot straight to Richie Dharmapala. Richard shows and goes, breaks one tackle, breaks two, runs inside, puts a little punt. And he's chasing. Crucial bit of work done there by Lee Keagle. Absolutely brilliant stuff by Keagle, but Candy still with position. This is dangerous. Candy is absolutely dangerous here. Veeraratna now straightening it up, gives it to Danish Karanjan, who loses the ball forward. Fortunately for the Sailors, unfortunate for Candy.
Look at the number of bodies on the knees, bodies, hands on the hips, how much end-to-end stuff this one. Look at the replay. In fact, there's a tackle on Gayan Veeraratna, but this is a knock-on by Danish Karanjan. But initially it was Richard Dharmapala. How sensational is that man? He always, when he gets the ball, he beats the first tackle.
I just can't understand why a team would kick to him. But every time he gets the ball, he beats one tackle in two tackles, and he always manages to get the ball away. So I just find it puzzling why any team would want to kick anywhere near him.
Absolutely. Richard Dharmapala did not have best of his outings against CRNFC. He could have done much better against CRNFC, but this time around, he's already created one try and he's looking very dangerous.
Well, he's created one try, but this first time he caught the ball, I noticed he was a little bit deeper. He saw that there was space. He worked hard to take the ball really flat, and that gave an opportunity to make a big break. The next time he came in and got the ball, he was coming from the blindside wing, and he came in and made the extra numbers, and they almost scored in the corner. This time he's taking the ball. He recognised there was space on the other side of the players who were in front of him and kicked over, and he almost collected the ball and scored a try himself.
So far it has been all Candy. Navy did have a small phase that they were building up, but they couldn't finish it up with unnecessary mistakes. But penalties have been the undoing of Navy so far, Sabir.
Let's go, fellas. Also, the decision making, Sudarshana. We saw that early on, Nivanka Prasad's decision making inside the red zone. And this kick, previous kick by Chanaka Chandimal, probably he just could not execute the direction of the kick. It just went straight into Richard Dharmapala. Probably should have gone another 10 or 15 meters backwards to Richard Dharmapala.
And again, interesting, Sabir, because when Chandimal did kick that ball, he was outside the 22. Point. So he had to make sure that he touched the ground as well. So he couldn't kick it out in the full. Now Richie Dharmapala in a pressure position. Nivanka Prasad gives it out to Chandimal, who desperately kicks the ball out, and which lands on the Navy bench.
Yeah, so that's the area where I'd be kicking the ball. I'd be kicking it into the stands. You don't want to give the opportunity at all to give the wing three quarters from Candy the ball and open space and time. Those three things for those guys means try time.
Absolutely. So 22 minutes into this game, and it has been played at absolutely brilliant pace, to be honest. And two teams, they are giving it their all. Candy, remember, needs to win this with a bonus point to keep their title hopes running. And Navy also need to win this one to keep their title hopes running. It's a three-horse race, this style of club rugby league. Paul, that's the other one which we were looking at, the short pass in the front. Seems like they've heard all our conversations, and here comes Dharmapala again. Has Fazil Marija, who goes under the post. Richard Dharmapala, absolutely brilliant stuff. And Fazil Marija, Candy's golden boy, scores under the post. Navy has no answers.
But no one's got any answers for Dharmapala today. He is on fire. As I said earlier, every time he touches the ball, he does something special. His pace and acceleration is electric. He took that ball, and then he made everyone standing around him look like they were standing still.
He
takes off here. They managed to get one hand on him. He's got ball in both hands. Where's he going to go? He's going to keep running? Is he going to pass it? He passed the ball back inside. Puzzle goes over. Under the post, that's probably going to be 7 points.
Indeed, he was screaming at Gayan Veeraratna to come inside and support him for the scissor pass, but Fazil Marija, former captain, welcome back to the ground, and he scores under the post. Brilliant stuff by Candy, and especially Richard Dharmapala. He's been, so far, he has made so many meters.
So two more points added by Thillina that time, so brilliant stuff from Candy. And Richard Dharmapala, talking about him, Sabir, it was his birthday yesterday so he's putting up a show. New year, new start. What a game he's playing so far.
Well, I'm sure he wants the bragging rights around the family table, so when his brother and his family are all having dinner next time, he'll be able to say, yeah, that's right brother, I'm the one who's won it.
So far from Dharmapala Brothers. Richard on top in this game as Shehan Lema Pathirana collects it and goes to the ground. Vishwamitra Jayasinghe now crashes in on Tharindu and goes unnoticed. Marita gives it out to Ranjan. Back to Dharmapala now. Dharmapala running in with that little run. He reminds you of Sanjeev Jayasinghe, who was also from Science College and was a sensational wing three-quarter for Kandy Sports Club. Fossil Marita. Runs it now, gives it to Gayan Veeraratne. Veeraratne to Dharmapala. Kick and chase by Dharmapala, has two men. Bounce is good for him. Can he go all the way? Yes, he does. Nothing's going wrong for Richard Dharmapala. How about that for a try? Absolutely brilliant stuff.
So the referee.
Referee needs to stay.
Sam George Jones wants to go upstairs.
Referee wanted to go upstairs.
Tony, my question is, the last play, when the ball bounced, there was some contact between the red and the blue player. I believe it was okay. So can you give me any reason not to award the try, please?
So the referee is now looking for any reason that why he cannot award the try. There you go, that's the kick.
He's going to come back to me.
Richard Dharmapala chasing it. Richie Dharmapala, the one there, fends off his brother. Brotherly love there. No love lost. Yes, Tharindu Chaturanga trailing back in. Thilna Veerasinghe. That's the grounding. That's good. That looks absolutely all right.
The was quite late. It's a try. There is no offense at all. You can award a try.
You're saying I can award a try?
Yes, you are. It's a try. Green try.
Thank you. I'm going to award a try.
So that's the confirmation. For all the good work by Dharmapala, he gets a try for himself, Sabir.
Brilliant, brilliant stuff. That's what he was trying previously, but here we go. The time has come for him. But look at the work. Look at the fitness level this man has previously from Gayan Veeraratne's pass. Let's look at this conversion. That's a successful conversion by Vijayasinghe. Previously from Gayan Veeraratne's pass, he made a few yards. Then he got back and come back. He made another 10 meters and then... Here you go for another beautiful kick and chase try, and also the bounce of the ball favoring him as well. That's the man on your screen, number 14, Richard Dharmapala, for you.
So the game plan for Kandy, pass the ball to that man there, the man in screen, because he can do no wrong today. So at half time he should go away and buy some lottery ticket or something like that, because he is onto a winner.
And mind you, we are all raving about Richard Dharmapala. But remember, Kandy Sports Club have match winners in Dhanush Karanjan, Gayan Veeraratne, Roshan Veeraratne, Fasil Marija is still to come to play, as Navy managed to get hold of that ball. Still not managed. Now finally he gets his knees on the ground, so Kandy needs to release him. Navy, can they make something of this one? The Dolanjana Vijayasinghe goes into contact. They desperately need to get at least one score. Supun Piris.
Release Red!
Navy still with position. Dreadful mistake there by Satya Ranatunga. Nothing going right. Nothing going Navy's way so far. Paul, they haven't been able to penetrate that advantage line for the Sailors. They've had trouble. I think they are lacking in confidence. They have to face wave of attack of Kandy.
Well, it's not just that. In defence, Kandy are bringing in a flyer or a scout or something like that. A player's coming out of the line, and so they have three or four players in the line are coming up. who the Navy player can see. On the blind side of that Navy player is a Candy player coming up and making the hit here. And so they're bringing a man from outside in, and that's the defensive difference.
Bring it up.
The dangerous thing with that defense is, though, if you can transfer the ball, the area that that man came from, the player that came outside in, that area is now a hole. And if Navy can transfer the ball and they can exploit that hole, there's a danger there as well.
25 points to 3, a lot of work to be done for Navy.
Bind! Set! Wait!
Roshan Veeraratne with the put in. Can they decide to keep the ball inside? Penalized straight away. Good decision by Udangamua. Danushka Gurta Pereira that time was the culprit. Breaking away from the scrum before it was over.
Well, the referee, I just heard through my headphones that he's saying that they're not staying in the contest.
They're dominant, you haven't stayed in.
So one side was dominant, one side wasn't. And they didn't stay in the contest and they relaxed one side. And that's what wheeled that scrum around.
Candy more than happy to kick the ball out and gain some yardage. Sabir, this has turned the game on its head. Three tries in quick succession. Candy straight away in the driving seat.
Yeah, they just need one more try for that bonus point, Sudarshan, and also 25 points to 3. But after that scrum win, good to see Fazil Marja coming and applauding the forwards. And here goes Candy now. That's the turnover this time. Leek Eagle, it's a 2-on-1 situation, but he puts a kick. And Salia Hanapangoda gets the loose ball, and the kick just finds Danushka Ranjan and the touch.
But what was that kick? So they had a break. There was a 3-on-2. He sort of ran across the field. Here we see here, great hit there by the number 7, I think, from the Navy team. Just players flooding through. Now this 3-on-2, uses up all the space and then just shins the ball. So what he needs to do there is really run at the player and draw and pass. Would have been a 2-on-1 then after that, and they might have been in for an opportunity to score. Might have had an opportunity to score a try, but now they have a line out 40 metres from the try line.
Can they come away with it with Roshan Veeraratne taking the ball into contact? Dimitri Vijayathunga taking the ball in. Supported by Yakub Ali. Bonik Udangamu goes in now. Accidentally offside, says the referee, so Navy with the ball.
Accidental obstruction.
Yeah, so there's a little bit of obstruction there. So the players that are in front, they're called the pillars. And so when your player picks up the ball, you've got to make sure you don't run into your pillar. If you do run into your pillar, that's called obstruction, and that's exactly what happened there. So Navy actually got away with one there, but fantastic work at the line out from, as we see a replay of, it just runs into the number 6. But I've seen the line out from Candy has been excellent, superb. They're collecting their own ball. They're stealing ball from Navy as well. Their set piece has been superb today. And it's really laying the foundation for their winger, Richard Darren-Papala, to play so well.
And how about that set? Talking about set pieces, good pressure put in at the scrum. Nivanka Prasad smashed by Bhuvana Kodangamu. Supun Pieris has come onto the field in place of Roshan Ranasinghe, the skipper. So that change we were talking about coming in early. Sajid Saranga goes in, but
tackle,
good tackle right. Coming in from Fasil Marija. Richie Dharmapala now gives it out to Chandimal. Chandimal floats it to Sali Handapangoda. Handapangoda running. Bhuvana Kodangamu is going to be in trouble that time.
Number 16, please. 16?
What?
So we have the first one, it was reactionary. This one was a bit more dangerous. It's going to the bin.
So here we see the yellow card come out for number 16. He's saying that the first time there was a tackle that was high, that was a reaction. This time it was a little bit more intentional. So young Sam George Jones from WA, from Perth. He's not frightened about using a yellow card, and that's been passed down from the World Rugby on the 3rd of January. We were spoken about this earlier, that any dangerous play, any high tackles, if it's a dangerous tackle, the minimum's a yellow card. If it's a dangerous, if it's an accidental tackle where tackles happen and the head's been hit, then that's a penalty minimum. But this time it was a dangerous tackle, so that's why he's sitting out for 10 minutes.
So this is the replay. There you go, straight away he goes to the neck. Players need to be absolutely, absolutely careful. With the new rules coming in, anything about the shoulder height, you're going to get penalised. You'll be lucky if you're only penalised, because you will end up in the naughty chair, just like Odangamua. And there you go.
Straight away, straight away.
Straight away, Candy doing very well to sack that one. They have a numerical disadvantage, but Navy will be looking to put everything here. They need a score. They absolutely need a score here. Just 5 minutes to go in the first half. The London Vijaysingha goes in with the ball. Richie Dharmapal to Nivanka Prasad. Nivanka Prasad brought to the ground by the Candy defense. Chanaka Chandibal changes direction. Sali Handapangudu, what a break! What an absolute break! Referee decides that it's a try. So try scored. Absolutely brilliant stuff. Handapangudu out of nowhere. Chanaka Chandibal deciding to change direction. And Nithavela falls silent.
It's not the first time that there's been a little bit of space down the blind side. So they come open a couple of times, and then they notice there's space on the blind side, and the winger stays wide and just catches his opposite number, Richard Dharmabala, a little bit inside, and he just ran through and ran a really hard, good line. It's great recognition of space there by Navy, but
Marcus, nice breathe.
Also good belief, yeah. And you can see that the referee comes across and just asks the referee's assistment.
That's the touchdown call, yeah. That's the touchdown.
Thanks.
Yes, you can see the assistant referee. He's pointing out as well. But it was a clever thinking, good communication between the scrum of Rishi Dharmapal and Chandimal. Switching that direction, it's a decision which taken in ample time once again. But Rishi Dharmapal, a credit stream, and credits to Navy Sports Club to score that try. So 8 points to 25 with the conversion to come.
So is that a turning point? That yellow card, you know, it's already let them back into the game, let Navy back into the game. But if they're going to get back into this game, they've got to start winning some contact. So every contact we're seeing at the moment between Navy players and Candy players, Candy's coming out on top. Navy aren't managing to get over that advantage line. Every time they're tackled, they're going backwards. And every time Candy take the ball forward.
Absolutely nails it there, telling Avirasinghe. What a player he's turned out to be for Navy Sports Club. Highest point scorer last time around. This time, first up, he converts a 53-meter penalty. And next up, he scores
from... have 3 minutes, 10 to go.
...the touchline. This is what you need. One player to put his hand up and say, here, guys, let's regroup. Nivanka Prasad now. Much better collection than last time. Navy penalised again for holding on. Brilliant work done by Shehan Patirana. Roshan Veerarathna takes the quick tap. Navy, not 10 metres. They need to be careful. There you go. Not 10 metres, so they will get the advantage. A quick shout out to my good friend Shihab Sawari joining us and all the viewers.
2.5 to go.
Who are watching us on this clash.
Not back 10.
And Candy opt to take the 3 points. Of course, they will try and use the most time they can with 14 men on the park. Good decision there.
Yeah, so I would have thought that, as a coach with my coaching hat on, I would have wanted my player not to take that quick penalty, because what you want to do is at least take some time to deliberate on what you're going to do. That might eat up another 30 seconds. Then you say, oh, should we go over the line? Should we take a shot of goal? We'll take a shot of goal. It's another 90 seconds. So that's a couple of minutes. You try to eat away that 10 minutes where you're numerically challenged.
So that's another successful kick by Thirina Vijay Singh. Candy 28 and Navy, it's 10 for them with one try, one conversion and a penalty. But still Candy playing with a man down. Buna Kaudangam with a man who went into the naughty chair for that high tackle on Salia Hanapangoda. And we're just, that's a penalty kick by Vijay Singh. And here's the restart now. Thirina Vijay Singh. He puts a high, very high kick. And Roshan Veeraratna, the man who calls for it.
Backwards.
Once again, another penalty advantage.
Knock on at
In
the
fact,
back.
It's a knock on.
Knock on.
In fact, it's a knock on by Candy.
I think there's about three knock ons there. He was just playing around with the ball as just a little bit back too far, and he just kept on knocking the ball on.
But how about the impact Supam Peris has made so far in this game? He's been substituted earlier on in the first half. They've taken the skipper out. That's a big decision, Paul.
That is a big decision, but as I said, they want to start winning some contact. They need to add, they need to change something up. They need to add something else to the team. And I don't know whether it was him coming on or whether now they've got a yellow card and they've got numerical advantage. I'm not sure what it was, but now they have to take advantage.
Remember, this is 7-8 scrum, but Navy not being able to control that ball. Tanaka Chandimal, a quick chip and chase. Danish Kagurta Pereira goes in with the ball. And they've been penalized for not releasing the tackler. So Navy slowly but surely climbing their way back into this game.
Decision time now for Navy, because whether to go for the 3 points or go for a quick tap and run, because if they kick this out, it's a halftime call. Perhaps they could opt another scrum. This is what you need to take the decision.
Sabir, it's not definitely not going to be a quick tap. If at all, it'll be a tap because they've taken all the time. Now they decide they're going for a scrum. 7-8. They have the numerical advantage. What they need to do is they need to keep the ball inside that scrum and try and shove Candy over, because they've got numbers now.
Well, the reason why the scrum's an advantage is because you've got seven players from Candy who are tied up inside that ruck. So it's tied up inside that scrum. So that's seven players who are not in the defensive line. Gives your backs more opportunity, more space, more time to attack, and hopefully they can do something with it, as from a Navy point of view.
Nivanka Prasad breaks. Sean Lema trying to hold him. But good ball carrying by Nivanka Prasad. Here's Navy now. Man numbers on the shorter side. Rishi Dharmapala needs to send the ball quickly.
Hold, wide, wide.
Another pick and drive.
Absolutely interesting placement by the referee to
number two
to counter that offside line. He plays advantage for Navy. So Navy with advantage. Navy just 6 to 7 meters away from that try line. Richie Dharmapala sends it out to the lantern of Vijay Singha. Beg your pardon, Satya Ranatunga that time. The penalty comes. Quick tap taken by Dulanjan and Vijay Singha. Can he go all the way? No, he's stopped in his tracks. Richie is squirming for that ball but doesn't get it. Ball held up, says the referee. So that is half time. 28 points to 10. Candy in a commanding lead so far. Paul, what did you take out this first half? It was played at a furious pace. What would your summary and the analysis be at the end of this first half?
Well, look, Candy came out of the blocks there. They played a magnificent first half. They really attacked Navy. Navy haven't had an opportunity to get into the game. They just started getting in the game for the last 5 minutes of this half. Really, they need to stay under the game. We know that they've got great fitness. At the back end of the second half, they'll be coming strong. So they need to hold on to Candy. Candy will come again in the second half. The first 5 minutes, first 10 minutes of the second half will be very fierce from Candy as they go in 28 points to 10 leaders.
That's right, Paul. That last penalty was just in vain for Navy Sports Club. They tried hard to get that 7-pointer. They could have taken 3 points and go to the Lemons, but unfortunately, the luck is not with them on that occasion.
They asked the question, actually, do we have time to have a shot at goal and then come back again? How much time have we got? He said, this will be the last play. So they went for it. They decided, okay, now let's go for this. Let's go for the 7 points. We've got an advantage now. It didn't come off, but that's the throw of the dice. They tried for it. It just didn't happen.
So there you go. The highlights of the first half. That was the first try. Richard Dharmapala giving it out to Danush Karanjan, drifting onto the outside and giving it out to him. Easy work for Danush Karanjan. Picks up from where he left from the CRNFC game. Look at that picture. Beautiful stuff.
He's just too fast, isn't he? He can't give him that much space. So they gave him a lot of space on the outside. He actually had another player on the outside him as well. So Navy were compressing their defence on the inside. This is where the penalty gets given away, I think, for holding on there.
Navy actually were very guilty of indiscipline because they did give away 6 to 7 penalties in the first 10 minutes of the game, which relieved a lot of pressure from Kandy and gave them attacking space. And there you go, Tilna Veerasinghe banking that 53-meter kick. Not an easy task, especially in Nithavella. It's always difficult.
Yeah, it's hard to see where the wind actually comes from here in the stadium, because you see the flags, you look down one end and the flag's going one way, you look at the other end, the flag's going the other way. But here we go, here's a Richard Dharmapala show. He just shows and goes, where's it going to go? It goes on the inside to Fazil and he scores under the post. But his acceleration in that try was amazing. And
absolutely, and Dharmapala did have Kayan Veeraratne on the outside as well. And how about this one for the try? Fends off his own brother, Richie Dharmapala, has no chance and goes all the way. He's a happy man. Look at that.
So he had a hand in all three tries there. Made the last pass on two of them. Scored one
and assisted two. Dharmapala is having a good birthday celebration so far. And that was the final try scored in the first half. That was by Navy Sports Club Salih Handabanguda, the one who scored that try. And that's where Tilna Veerasinghe cut down the deficit. The Lanterna trying hard, but was met with furious defense. I feel for the Lanterna. He's trying to do a lot of things, but he's not supported today by his teammates very well.
Well, it's not that he's not getting the support. It's that Kandy there is stopping him at every point of contact. Wherever there's contact, Kandy are there, and they're not letting them pass. So that'll have to change if Navy are going to get back into this match. They'll have to try and get over the advantage line somehow. They've got to start winning some contact. But they need to hold on to the game at the moment, because there's still only 18 points in it. It may sound like a long way, but we saw how quickly Kandy accrued points. We can see Navy do the same as well, and they still have a numerical advantage as they go on.
And do join us on the most popular club rugby player of the year 2016-17. There is a contest going on www.thepapere.com. All you got to do is place your vote for your most favourite player. 8 players have been shortlisted: Charit Seneviratne, Irangarya Pala, Dulaj Pereira, Dulanjana Vijayasinghe, Richard Dharmapala, who's showed up today, Rohit Rajapaksa, Tarinda Ratwatte, and Radhisha Seneviratne are the shortlisted players. You can vote once every day, every 24 hours you can vote once. So do go in and vote for your favourite player. And from the readings that we have now, Radhisha Seneviratne is in a comfortable lead. And this competition will be open until 5th of February. So go in and cast your vote. And it has been an absolutely thrilling first half. Do bear with us as we go for a commercial break and join you with a thrilling second half. Kandy Sports Club hosting Navy Sports Club.
Hi, welcome to Hope Centric Yoga. I'm your host, Hope. Thanks thanks for watching. Do subscribe to thepopery.com. Special thanks to Body Bar for the location and iFilm Sri Lanka for the video production. Follow me on Instagram at featherpalm_fox.
The Recap, your daily sports update. Wherever you are, tune in to thepapare.com at 6:30 p.m. on the dot and be updated on what happened around you.
The Hero Cup second ODI between Sri Lanka and Australia. Australia leading the series 1-0. The news is that Angelo Matthews has won the toss.
Hey guys, I'm Isuru, this is Natasha. We are Revolution Athletes and we are the founders of Fit.lk.
So basically, we are partnering with the Papare to bring you a mini series called Workout Right with Fit.lk. We're gonna help educate you on how to get the most out of your workouts. And not only that, we're gonna motivate you through the fitness journey you're about to start. So stay tuned. And get fit the right way.
Hi, welcome to Hope Centric Yoga. I'm your host, Hope. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe to thepopery.com. Special thanks to Body Bar for the location and iFilm Sri Lanka for the video production. Follow me on Instagram at featherpalm_fox.
Dharmapala. And here we go. Great crowd here at the Nitavala grounds, and welcome back to Dialogue TV Channel 1 and Papare.com on your number one sports hub. Referee Jones Sam George, all the way from Western Australia. Arna Shanta and Shaminda Muthumala, the assistant referees, and the TMO for today, Tony Amit. And Fazil Marija to take the restart, former Candy captain. Candy leading 28 points to 10. Three tries in the first half, one try away for the bonus points try. Here's the restart, Dulanjana Vijayasinghe takes the ball and straight away bumped into Suhiro Anthony. Neri had an opportunity just before the half-time with that penalty decision, but unfortunately they could not make that into a point. That's a...
It's a nice little conventional play there from Navy. They took the ball into contact and then just cleared the ball out, cleared their lines. They've taken play up to probably about 30 metres out, 35 metres out from their own try line. So they just want to settle the game down a bit. They want to take some of the sting out of Candy as well. But now they need to start winning some of the contact. So what the coach, I saw the coach Art pleading with his players there at halftime. He wants some heart and soul put into this match. They have to take it personally. You have to take it personally, and you have to beat the player who's opposite you. Yeah, and that needs to be done personally.
Candy with a driving maul now. Marching forward, Navy not committing much numbers. Candy have already conceded one try with one player down. Dimitri gives it to Fasil Marita, gives it to Richard Dharmapala, but this time he stops in his tracks. Forward pass says the referee, so Marita not getting the execution right that time.
Yeah, that's right, but look, defensively from Navy, you know that there's one man you've got to mark, and that's the man that they just tried to pass to. Even though it was forward, you know the ball's coming his way, and you saw in that replay, they had him covered.
It's just touch and go, I think, but just in front of the referee, the ball looked like it came backwards, but Farzin Marija's hands moves forward on that occasion.
Touch! Point!
Candy is back to its original number. Bone Kodangamo has made the field. The back of the scrum, you see eight players against eight. Nivanka Prasad now. He's smashed there by Dimitri Vijayathunga. Bone Kodangamo rather. Lee Kegel now gives it out to Lahiru Hera. Til Navira Singha banks it down. In the 22.
Offside.
Line offside, says the referee. So before the game, we did have a chat with the referee, and he was not going to give any quarter. He was going to be very, very harsh on the offside position. Just checking the ball that time. There you go, Lee Kegel clearly in front. Good spot by the referee. And he wants the ball to be changed. Candy now straight away with the chance. Brilliant touch by Tilnaviris Vijayasinghe there.
I just saw Lee Kegel. He's still going back and still shaking his head. He can't believe it. He needs to see the footage. He was offside, but he needs to let that go. He needs to move to the next task, and the next task is trying to hold their lines here. So they're 7-8 metres out from their own try line. They must hold them out here. If Candy start with a hiss and a roar again and score another try in the second half, the game might just slip away from Navy.
Damidisan Aika now with the put in.
Once
says the referee, so they need to use this ball. Candy still trying to drive. Yakub Ali transfers it to Veeraratne. Now to Richard Dharmapala, gives it out to Danish Karanjan in space. Dangerous man in space. How about that for a tackle? Brilliant tackle coming in. And Danushka loses the ball. This is what Navy needed. They wanted to win the contest, and this is exactly what Navy needed.
That's right. You can see Ranjan's going into contact here, and then he quickly puts the car into reverse and straight onto his back, and that's why he's on his back now. He's getting a little bit of attention. Referee calls time off, but that was a bone rattler, and they know. He'll know he's in a game of rugby now.
Number 20, blue.
Satya Ranatunga that time giving it his all, using his upper body strength and crashing in. Stefan Gregory makes the field for Navy. Be interesting to see for whom he comes in. He's come in place of Kanchana Pereira. So interesting move there.
Are the subs all good?
Brilliant pictures brought to you by our production crew.
Time's back on. Scrum.
And that's exactly what we wanted to see from Navy, Paul, winning that contest, exactly what you spoke about. Now this will give them some confidence. They've smashed hard, they've won that individual contest. They need to put this good work.
Points.
2 points.
Well, they firstly, they need to take care of the scrum, because the last scrum they were destroyed. And they haven't been strong in the scrum. They've had one good scrum so far in this game. They need another one. They need to start sneaking back a little bit of the advantage that Candy have.
Stefan Gregory has made that front row. He's a big forward who's come in. So he will be making his impact felt in that scrum.
Sets!
Ali Hadapangadu puts a kick and Richard Dharmapala sends it back to Dulanjana Vijay Singha. And Dulanjana, the hooker, puts a very good kick.
All good.
Into the 22, and Tilina Vijay Singha this time. It's been a football kicking contest. End-to-end kicking stuff. But that's a good distance gained by Tilina Vijay Singha. From the 22, he made almost 40 meters.
He absolutely took that as an insult where Dulanjana kicked it. And remember, I'm a kicker. Okay, I represented Sri Lanka under 19 as a football player. So this is my reply.
How many? Five.
Oh, look at that. Making all the hookers proud. Dulanjana Vijay Singha. Last game, we saw Omalka Gunaratne doing the same thing.
We saw Dulanjana kicking at the warm-ups. Even Paul Toya from commentary box, why are you kicking with the knee strap? He said it's perfectly fine. So here you go.
Vijay Singha now sends it out, but line out won by Candy. Damit Dishanayake takes the ball into contact. But lost forward, says the referee. So Navy again with the chance. Candy haven't had possession in this second half for them to run.
Here's your mark.
Yeah, just a little bit inaccurate there. An inaccurate throw, so the throw is a little bit short. And then a little knock on, and a little loss. The ball's just lost forward there, you can see in the replay.
Damit Dishanayake was trying to transfer it to Ganaka Dishanayake, but the ball was lost.
Points! Set.
Keep an eye out for Nivanka Prasad, who looked to break from the open side. He decides to give it out to Chanak Chandimal. Lee Keagle goes crashing in. Marija goes in and tackles Keagle. Looked like a knock forward, but referee says it's all right. Nivanka Prasad again. Dharmapala to Sali Handapanguda. Handapanguda gets into space, but he's finally tackled. Supun Piris loses his footing. Navy have numbers on the outside. Can they make something of this one? Herat gives it out to Supun Dilshan. He's tackled. Can they need to organize their defensive structure? Richie Dharmapala now to Herat. Lahiru Herat still going. How about that for an offload? Is this the try that's going to turn the game around? Navy Sports Club scores with Lee Keagle, the man scoring that try.
Oh, Lee Keagle, you beauty. Sensational stuff by Lairo Herat. He's the man who was hidden so far. Where was he? He was thinking, if the opposite centers can run, why can't I run? There he comes to the action, and a brilliant pass. And Lee Keagle goes to the whitewash. So game on, says Navy, Paul.
That was all set up there by Richie Dharmapala. He just saw a half gap. He went, ghosted through that gap, got the ball away. Herat, he was excellent. Drew players to him. Lee Keagle saw the line. He saw him take off. And then he brings the ball around. Just teases those Candy players. And then he turns around and gives it to the crowd behind the posts.
Here you go from another angle. Lahiru Herat, Dami's Vishwamitra. Evades the tackle of Veerasinghe and gives it out beautifully to Lee Keagle. If Navy was looking for a rip-right try, it can't get better than this. Two centers combining with each other. Beautiful try.
I think Roshan Veeratna, the captain, had a word with the referee. Perhaps the last pass looked marginally forward. Maybe he wants to have a word with the referee. I'm not sure whether we can get a replay on the last pass to Lee Keagle. If we can get after this conversion. But referee was spot on, but you deserve a try, for, especially for that move, isn't it, Paul?
Yeah, that's right. He did deserve a try. It was a great move, and it was great great endeavour there by Navy. They haven't given up. They haven't given up belief, and they're believing their own process. So they're going to keep on taking it to Candy. What Navy do so well is they always hit down the blind side. So they always come back. They hit up through the middle, and then there's players flooding the blind side. And that time it worked for them. Let's see if they can do it again.
Remember, rugby is an 80-minute game, and anything can happen. And Navy, don't discount them. They are here to play. That's the replay of that try. We can watch it over and over again. Brilliant work by Lahiru Herat. And Lee Keagle putting on the finishing touches. As we restart, Richie Dharmapala. Richie decides to kick from the base. Collected by Bhuvana Kodangamu, is held by Salih Handapangoda. Still on his feet.
Always on the man. After shot, clear release.
There you go, the instructions are clear from the referee. You need to release the man.
So you throw a clear release when you make the tackle.
Supan Perius was the tackler assist and not the tackler who went in for the ball, but Lahiru Herat also has his hands in the rug.
That's right, he said he always had his hands on the ball, and the player actually doesn't become the tackled player until his knee hits the ground. So as soon as his knee hits the ground, then you've got to release the player, and there wasn't any clear release, and that's why the penalty came.
Sure, I'll have a look at it for you.
So absolutely good chase by Navy, but undone again with a penalty. Now Tilna Vijayasinghe banks the ball to the side, and the breakdown ins and outs of the Club Rugby League will be brought to you by Sabir Kader and Shanak Amarasinghe. Midweek, log into www.thepapare.com, where you will be able to catch the ins and outs of this interesting Club Rugby League 2016-17. Referee bringing the play back.
Well, time was off. You can't play and you can't take a kick when the time's off. So a player was getting medical treatment. The referee called timed off. Then they took the kick and he just brought the play back.
So Candy 21. Trying to get that urgency back again.
21.
Candy, they don't have any urgency. They are just walking to the line out like a group of pensioners killing all the time. And here's a replacement. As Suranga Pushpakumara comes into the field and the crowd goes booing.
Remember this man, Suranga Pushpakumara. There is a lot of animosity between Suranga Pushpakumara and the Candy crowd, a homegrown player, but he has been a player for Navy Sports Club, and he's had his run-ins with the crowd, run-ins with the players in the previous games, just like in English football. Suranga Pushpakumara, every time when he gets the ball, he's going to listen to some booing, but he will know how to channel it to get the better of his game. Candy with a short line-out. Veeraratna.
Frustration signs from the Candy forwards and the Flyer Fazil Marija, not happy with that line out. And it's a free kick, not a penalty, mind you. So just inside the 22, so Chanaka Chandimal can gain the distance. And that's a lovely kick to come into the opposite territory.
Beautiful old style torpedo kick there. So if you're from my generation, that's the kick that you used to try and do all the time as a young child. Obviously, it's not as accurate, and often you can get it a little bit wrong and it goes off the side of the boot, but that time a beautifully executed.
There you go.
The crowd starting to come into the game and get a little bit.
There you go. That was the reason why the free kick was awarded. Not straight. It goes right into the hands of Yakub Ali. It needs to go in the channel, into the middle. This time around, it'll be interesting to see Shehan Patirina gets the ball. And Candy set up a driving maul straight away.
No! Advantage!
Still on the march, Candy.
In the side, and
this time, Navy penalised.
Number five.
Coming in from the side, says the referee. Clear instructions given.
So in the side and collapsing is the referee's call.
But that's a smart work by Candy. They're not using all the men in the lineout, just a four-man lineout, and they're winning a penalty driving that. And then the support arrives on time. So number five, Supun Pieris, I think, was the culprit on that occasion.
So the Candy lineout has been excellent today. It's been a real lesson. Every single, except for the one where they did that short one that wasn't straight, but every other lineout we've seen has been an excellently executed, accurate lineout play. That time the ball was taken down so quickly, they set with a five-man driving ball. It was beautiful to watch.
Let's see what tactics they will use here. Again, they're going for the four-man lineout. This time there is a Navy hand. Buone Kodangamo goes crashing in. Sucks in a lot of defenders from Navy Sports Club. Viraratna, show and go. Goes in himself. Kasun De Silva, the tackler for Navy Sports Club. Yakub Ali, pick and go, needs support. He didn't wait for a player to come. Damidi Sanaka, acting halfback, gives it out to Dimitri.
Ball is out.
Dimitri now gets the ball to the 5-meter mark. Tarindu Chaturanga takes the ball in.
Time you're on, hold.
Tilna Vijayasinghe finds himself there, but Ganuka says move on. Dimitri.
Blew away. Let it come.
Sailors need to roll away. Fasil Marija now to Gayan Viraratna. Big man goes crashing in. Candy now threatening in 5 meters. And penalized there. Holding on, says the referee.
Holding on with blue hands on top of him is the call from the referee. They really dodged the bullet there though, Navy. They had numbers on the far side for Candy. There was Ranjan and Richard Darumapala were outside if the ball had come. So there, hands are on him. I think this is the ruck here where the penalty comes. So here, falling on the ground. Hands are on him now. He's got to release the ball. Obviously the referee didn't think that. He released it quick enough.
Navy will be breathing a big, big sigh of relief there, because Candy looked absolutely threatening. Now with a chance to get out of jail, and they've done very well. There you go, the Navy supporters. They have something to cheer about this second half. Navy has been the dominant force so far because they've managed to score, Sabir.
Making a substitution.
That's right, and it'll be interesting also what type of changes will come in the next few minutes for both the teams. I think Roshan Viraratna is struggling once again. Remember, we were talking about this concussion before the start of this game. Last week also he went out.
Yeah, he's coming off.
Same, perhaps playing 50 to 60 meters, but this time it looked like the shoulder or the elbow maybe. Yeah.
All good.
I think it's the shoulder.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The left shoulder of Roshan Viraratna. Now here comes Srinath Suryabandara.
Nice bit of long distance diagnosis there by Dr. Kadir.
Talanjana this time decides to go short to the man in front. Chandimal now kicks it deep. Vishwamitra Jayasinghe with safe hands. Can Candy get the ball out quick? Suryabandara to Dimitri. Jayasinghe. Viraratna now has numbers. Viraratna gives it to Danish Kuranjan on the inside. Suryabandara, long pass out. Nice back of the hand pass by Buone Kodangamu to Damit Dissanayaka. Tilna Virasinghe, Vijayasinghe rather, with a drop goal attempt. Doesn't come his way.
Well, we saw it was successful last week against CR and FC, but this time he didn't quite get hold of the ball. So it's back to a 22 dropout for Navy. So Navy are just holding on to the game at the moment. They're 11 points behind. We believe that they might have the fitness
Firstly, Paul, it's not a bad decision to go try that attempt, because even if you miss that 22 restart, you're going to get the ball in favor of your side most likely. But Navy's defense has really improved, because Candy didn't have an option to run the or to work the ball out because of their defensive work. Compared to the first half, it has been really improved now.
Definitely, Sabir coach Motilal Jayatilaka would have had some harsh words for the Navy defenders. Now Ranjan to Dharmapala. Dharmapala gives it out to Kayan Veeraratne. Kayan Veeraratne, little kick and a chase. Tanaka Chandimal is there to save Navy, but good bit of play by Kayan Veeraratne. What a change this boy has brought into this Candy outfit.
Can you repeat, please?
With Kanchan Ramanayake getting injured, he steps into that number 12 jersey after injury. And look at that. The commitment he shows. Brilliant work. Tanaka Chandimal luckily was there for Navy Sports Club to save it and kick the ball out.
Oh, good.
But Candy still with a chance.
So what Candy doing so well is
time
that they just come back and they hold their depth so well out wide. So they're all running onto the ball with full pace. So it's really great work by the backs coaches and also by the players.
There has been a change. Danush Dayan coming in for Vishwamitra Jayasinghe. One Sri Lanka sevens prospect goes out with another replacing, and Candy now with a strong driving maul. Maybe still have no answers. Brings it down and is penalized. Referee is reaching out to his pocket. Stefan Gregory gets a yellow card. This is the last thing Navy Sports Club wanted at this time. Stefan Gregory was the man who got the yellow card. There you go. He's making his way out. The last thing Navy Sports Club wanted, Sabir, they were...
Here we go, a great opportunity for Candy to get their bonus point. They have waited so long. Now, especially with a big prop forward going into sin bin, Stefan Shehan Patiran now. Candy in the driving seat on the 5-meter mark. It's a testing time, highly testing time for Navy Sports Club. Who's got the ball? A try is given, not sure who the try scorer is. Looks like Buenaka Udangamo, the man who scored that try.
It's quite difficult to spot who scored that try. We'll take a look at the replay to see who had control of the ball.
So I thought it was excellent play there and excellent positioning there by the young West Australian referee. He was so decisive when he caught the ball. He was in perfect position. I thought he called number 4 and scored the try. But as soon as he saw that ball going down, he was, maybe 1 metre from the ball and just blew it straight away and said, try, we've done it. So,
Aru, can you get 1 and 8 off, please?
Here you go. The replay. Candy was very well set there. They knew they had the numerical advantage. Seems like Dimitri Vijayathunga, the number 5, is the one who has the ball in hand. That's right. He has been transferred. Seems like it's Bone Kodangamo, the number 16 jersey, the try scorer. How about that of putting icing on the cake? Touchline conversion by Veerasinghe. Brilliant stuff by the young man, Thilina Vijayasinghe rather.
That was a classic case that the crowd will tell you whether it's gone over or not.
So Candy managed to get their bonus point try. Now what they need to do is they need to put this game to rest. One more try could really put this game away from Navy Sports Club, Sabir. And if you were the Navy coach, what would your message be to the Sailors now?
Stay in control because it's a big loss that Stefan Gregory is out. Play the territorial game and they have to go for points, especially with these chances. Still, we got 18 minutes of play. We saw Thilina Veerasinghe going for a 53-meter kick, but Chanaka Chandimal, he's going to touch. and that gives an opportunity for into the red zone for the Sailors. So another scoring opportunity this lineout if they execute well.
Yeah, so they're 18 points behind. There's 18 minutes to go. They've got to do something. They're chancing their arm. Their lineout hasn't been functioning as well as it could have been doing. So now they've got an opportunity there now to fix that.
Tulanjana Vijay Singh with the throw
in. Line.
They have plenty of options in that Navy lineout. For the receiver, quick throw comes in, but very well collected this time. Ball's good there. Defending there by Candy, not letting the Navy maul set. Vijay Singh, very good tackle coming in from the Candy defenders, shoving, reversing the Lanjana back. The ball comes out. Supun Peris tackled on his tracks. Candy resilient on their defense. Chatur Dilshan goes into contact now. Chandimal to Supun Dilshan, who makes the ball available. Supun Peris now fumble with the ball but manages to keep it under control. Good work there, but gets himself tackled. Supun Dilshan. Oh, close there. Penalty, that's right.
No clear release.
Not releasing the tackle, says the referee.
Yeah, you have to shoot daylight.
Fasil Marija has a little word with the referee. Luckily, it's a foreigner who's refereeing. He wouldn't have gotten away that easy with the normal referees if he had to have a word with the referee.
Well, he's just asking the question, what was the problem there, referee?
Yeah.
And the referee just said you have to have clear release.
That's what.
So he wants clear directives to the players, just so that if they're going to make a mistake, let's not make it again a second time. So this is the reason why the penalties come. Looks like there might have been a little bit of head contact.
I thought it was a sack.
There hasn't been a decision communicated to the referee, but we can see slowly but surely they've won and bringing in the tee.
16.
He has the tee in his hand. 16 minutes left and Navy insistent on going into touch, and that's not a very good kick that they'll be proud of. That's not what they wanted to do.
It's not a good kick, but the problem that they're having at the moment is they throw in. So they threw in last time and they were, might have been, what, 10, 12 metres from the try line. After three rucks, they were 25 metres behind the try line, away from the try line. So they're not reaching the gain line. They're not getting over the advantage line. That's because they're not winning the contact. So what they're not doing is they're not coming back far enough and running onto the ball. You'll see they're taking the ball flat, and that's bringing the defence onto them.
Here's another line out taken nicely. Suranga Pushpakumara sending it to Satya Ranatunga, getting the ball from Chanak Chandimal. That's absolutely right. Navy's attacking line looks absolutely flat and very compact. Chandimal, good defensive work by Candy. Navy
hold!
Still has the ball in position. There's Supun Dilshan going into contact. Three defenders on him. Once again, another advantage coming to Navy. Kasun Silva. Now it's an interesting third penalty. What will the decision be? Now they have decided to take it up and run this time. Chandimal puts the offload to Herath. Looks like they don't trust their lineouts anymore, and that's a knock-on cardinal error by Satya Ranatunga. I don't think they have made the decision correctly in the last three penalties.
So three penalties, that's 9 points. At the moment, what are they? They're 18 points behind. They could have cut that deficit down to 9 points. So maybe in hindsight, looks like they might have taken the points, but that time they just tried to take the quick penalty and try and catch them offside and get another pinch, another 5-10 metres, but referee called it that he was onside and it was fine.
Absolutely, Paul. So decision making has been a problem this game so far for Navy. Fresh legs have
Touch!
Made the park. You can see Pumal Mantanayake
coming
in that first row in place of Ganaka Disanayake. Surya Bandara with the put in. Bhuvanekudangam goes slightly high
off
there.
Blue, thank you.
Was an arm around his neck.
Carried back.
Now Tilna Veerasinghe with a kick. Goes straight to the hands of Sali Handapangada, who's on the counter now. Runs across. First tackle not successful on him. Finally tackled by Danush Dayan. Lee Keagle, pick and go. Yakub Ali on the ground tackling him. Tanaka Chandimal tackled now. Navy finding it hard to penetrate that advantage line, and that's a penalty for Kandy. Now this will be interesting, Paul. Will Kandy go for points, or will Kandy opt to go to the touchline and go put in another try and put this game to rest for good?
Well, I think they've decided to take the points, but I think what they're going to do is just try and manage the game here now. They're 18 points up. They need to run down the clock. There's maybe 12 minutes, 13 minutes to go.
There's 13 minutes to go, okay? There's a few penalties against your team, okay? Mainly for going off feed, okay? Yeah. I watch their offside, so you just get your guys to stay positive, okay? On the left feed.
So the referee's just had a word to the captain from Navy and just said that there's a few penalties going against this team for going off their feet at the breakdown. The Navy captain came back with, what about their offsides? He said, well, I'll keep them onside if you keep your players on their feet. So that's a warning.
Very clear instructions given by the referee as we... No mistake there. Brilliant stuff by Tilina Vijayasinghe. Adds 3 more points. So for the question I asked you at the beginning of the game, Tilna Vijayasinghe seems to have taken the advantage, and he's definitely the man who's accumulating more points for his team, Sabir.
Absolutely, without a doubt. He was the man for me in the last game against Sierra FC because he created lots of try-scoring opportunities and made some lovely kicks also. That drop goal attempt was brilliant, and I'm sure Nigel Ratwatha will find hard to find get his number 15 shirt on.
Absolutely. When it comes to trouble in choosing a player, that's a good headache to have for the coach, Vijayasinghe. Now Kandy with the ball, running with space. Richard Dharmapala has space, kick. And now Navy in trouble. Surya Bandara collects it, and Kandy has the ball. Can they go in for another try? Yakub Ali, white line fever, they say. Finally offloads to Sehan Lima Patrana in front of the clubhouse. Kandy makes it a ritual to score in front of the clubhouse, Sabin.
Well, he's lucky he got the ball away when he's on the ground, because there's a man who was open on the outside of him, so he managed to get the ball away. But what a great chase, what a great kick from Richard Dharmapala. Here they bring it one way. Oh, this is the end of the move.
Maybe the pass should have gone earlier. Should have sent it, but Shehan Lewa Patirana finally touches the white line. That's right, Paul, absolutely. Credit to Richard Dharmapala once again. He's been the man so far. That kick and the lucky bounce to Srinath Surya Bandara, and lovely run and supportive work by Gayan Veeraratne. And he just did a simple thing, draw and pass. But Yakub Ali trying to be a bit selfish to put some signs to Sean Vijayasinghe. But good work by, good finish by Shehan Patirana.
So Guyan was involved in that twice, and twice he straightened the play. So he created the space there for Richard Dharmapala on this side. He just ran straight at the defence, made sure the defence came to him, gave him a little bit more space so he was able to get that kick away. And then it happened again on the other side. He created the space from the men on the outside.
And that looks unsuccessful this time by Tilna Vijayasinghe. But the reason for that, Paul, I think, is the set move and the breakdown. Look, Kandy, how far they are from the breakdown point. They have so much space. They have so much space, unlike Navy Sports Club, which is very flat and compact.
Yeah, that's right. So their realignment from breakdown and turnover ball has been superb. Good. Today. Yeah. Kandy have played like a champion team today. Everything they've touched has turned to gold.
Absolutely, and adding on to what you said about Gayan Veeraratne, Paul, I think he's changed the look of the Kandy outfit so much.
Yeah, it's come off you, onto that guy, it's accidental, it's a scrum.
Lost forward there, nobody wanted it initially for Kandy. But 43 points to 17 against Navy Sports Club. That's the reason why Candy's lost the ball. Tharindu Chaturanga having his hand in that.
8:30.
43 points to 17.
He just asked the referee how much time. What's the time? And he said it's 8:30.
Bind!
It must be 8:30 somewhere. It's not 8:30 here.
Sets!
Here we go. Another scrum. Suranga Pushpakumara sending it to Chandimal. To Lee Keegan. A good tackle by Guy and Veeratna. But he just knocks back, says a referee. And here's the kick and chase by Lai Rerat. Richard Dharmapala could not hold on to the ball. So has Suhiro Anthony. But Richard still with the ball inside the try line, inside the goal line. And that's going to be a 5-meter scrum in favor of Sailors.
Yeah. Hurry back.
I thought that was very lucky for Candy because that ball was collected in front and that was offside.
Yeah, it looked like the ball might have come off Richard Dharmapala. But the referee's just checking for some foul play or dangerous contact. Oh no, he's actually asking for subs.
That was a suggestion of a slide knock on there by Lee Keegle, but that's done. So replacements coming in the form of Kisho Jehan.
Time on.
Comes in for Bhuvane Kodangamu and Yakub Ali also making his way out. And Gayan Ratnayake in.
Crouch!
Damit Disanayake is not going to be a very happy man with that shot.
Well, look, you can see the Candy Hooker showing a lot of guts this year.
Navy with the chance now for a consolation try, but how about that for a scrum from Candy? Strong work. What can Navy do here? Can they go in and score?
Number two.
Referee playing advantage to Navy.
Playing advantage.
Navy still with the advantage. Pushpakumar to Chandimal. Chandimal puts a little chip. Referee will bring back play for the initial penalty.
So number two in the side, he said.
Luckily for Soiru Anthony, that tackle, he couldn't hold on to the player, but the player went on to the ground. Hearty defense coming in from Candy. They don't want the Sailors to score. Tulanjana Vijayasinghe. How about that awareness? Brilliant, brilliant stuff. Maduranga, the try scorer. Absolutely brilliant stuff by Tulanjana Vijayasinghe. This is exactly what Yakub Ali should have done earlier. Tulanjana showing off copybook stuff. If you are a forward young kid watching in the game, this is exactly what you need to do. It's not who scores the try, but the one who creates it. Look at that, unselfish, and puts him in space. Brilliant stuff.
It was a great try. It was copybook stuff. You saw him catch the ball early, transfer the ball easily across his body, was moving forward onto the ball, so the defensive player had to come to him, just put his winger on the outside and gave him enough space, and he managed to get over.
This is what, in fact, Yakub Ali should have done as well in the previous space, which was scored by Shan Limapatra. But this is the guy I was talking about. The little guy from under-19 Sri Lanka, Tanuja Malimba. Also, he was named as Tanuja Maduranga from Science College. He just beat his senior player, Richard Dharmapala, on that occasion. So, good science, good wingers coming from Science College also. And here's Thilina Veerasinghe.
Veerasinghe, you nailed this one. You are one to beat. So close, and it's never easy to kick conversions from this end of the Candy Sports Club field. But too little too late for Navy Sports Club. They managed to get that try, a consolation try maybe, but what they're going to kick themselves is going to be, because they are not going to go away with a bonus point even with the loss here. they'll be really heartbroken on that. 43 points scored against them.
Backwards overhead. Now flew.
Now Navy with a count on that regard.
Hold here, please. Wait.
Chandimal.
Timing's
puts the
good.
Ball to Boot. Lavanga under it, but the ball's. Take your mark. No time for a quick line out there.
No, it wasn't. It was no time. It was just he was in front of the mark, so he's got to be behind the mark. So he gets an opportunity to retake the throw-in.
Now we've got subs coming on.
But there was good speed of thought there from DeLangelo to try and continue the move.
When you're ready.
And the March Madness is on our way. Singer Under 19 Cricket Tournament is on the move. St. Thomas's College taking on Wesley College on 20th and the 21st. And as we speak, Navy Sports Club, Danish Caprera going into contact. Arshad Jamaldeen has made the field in place of Fasil Marija. Coach Vijay Singh are deciding that his ace fly-off has done his bit. Navy looking for some redemption here. Lost forward, Lema had his hand out there. Could have been interpreted as cynical.
One
each way, your crumb. DeLangelo was asking the referee to talk to the referee's assistant because the referee's assistant saw there was a knock-on from a Candy player. So that was correct. The referee's assistant is the referee's assistant because he assists the referee, so he helped him out there with that call.
Absolutely. Yet again.
Crouch!
David is not going to be very happy with these two prop forwards. They're making him look really bad.
Wait.
Navy with the free kick. Decides to take it quickly. How about that? Surya Bandara.
Hi on.
Taking on Chatur Dilshan. Clearly a mismatch when it comes to the physical sizes. Golanjana now. Marked by his opposite number, Damit. Pushpa Kumar to Chandimal, gives it out to Gregory. Gregory met by the combination of Patirana and Jamaldeen. Lahiru Herat, good offload. Danish Karanjan, goodbye, you're not going to catch this man. Takes all the time he wants and scores. Heartbreak when you say. Try Danish Karanjan. He started off scoring, seems like he'll finish off scoring as well.
He's just finishing the proceedings here today, but there was a little bit of an inaccuracy from the Navy backs. They had the numbers on the outside, the ball didn't quite go to hand, and here it just flicks up here. Now that pass there needed to go to hand. It gets it. Ranjan, clean pair of heels, shut the gate, the horse is bolted. But what I do like is the Navy players keep coming back, and they keep coming back, and they stop them from coming back around under the posts. Even though the game's gone, they still keep chasing, and that's what I like about a team with spirit. Excellent run there from Ranja.
If you give that man space, there is absolutely no catching him. Has too much space to burn, has too much legs.
15!
So Danish Karanjan with another try. 48 points with the conversion to come. And it's good. So 50 points.
So 50 points. So first time ever that they've put 50 points on Navy. But everyone was talking about the questions going to be asked. The questions going to be asked from the Navy team. And how is Candy going to respond? Well, they're going to respond by scoring 50 points against Navy when they come up here.
30, 32-37 was the story down in Ballyserra. But how about this for a reply? 50-point reply. And Kandy Sports Club unbeaten in their Nithavella Fortress. They weren't going to make that change. They still keep running, Kandy. Veeratna. Lavanga Pereira loses it, unfortunately.
One inch wide. Full time.
And referee decides that's the game. So that is the end of the story. Navy's title hopes are now dented. It'll be difficult. Kandy and Navy are in the same position now with Havelocks riding up. Havelocks will be having the last laugh. They'll be very happy team at the end of this week.
So there you have it. Kandy have answered all the critics. They've come back. They've lost two games.
And it's time for us to decide the man of the match. I don't think there is a question there. Man of the match would be Richard Dharmapala.
Yeah, he was so influential at the beginning of the game. Every time he touched the ball when the game was still in the balance, every time he touched it, he did something a little bit special. And that really turned the tide for them. I've got to say, though, that Kandy pack, they played magnificently. If you give it to eight players, I'd give it to the Kandy pack. But we've got to give it to Richard Dharmapala because he played so magnificently in the first 20 minutes when the game was in the balance.
Absolutely brilliant scenes here. Kandy players mixing and mingling with the Navy players. There have been some animosity and history between these two teams, but all is forgotten. Everybody celebrating together and having a good time. But Kandy Sports Club will be the happy outfit today. They've absolutely played like champions, as you said, Paul.
Well, there won't be one. One team won't be celebrating and one team won't be so happy with their performance. But Navy will be able to take a lot away from this performance. 50 points to 22 is a huge scoreline for Navy. Navy came here with a great defensive record. They had a much feared defence where they'd take the ball and they'd take on attackers and they'd really rush the attacking line. This time it was Kandy that did it the other way. The Kandy defence really came at Navy. And they gave Navy no space, no time, and they couldn't get over the advantage line because of it.
Here's that try in the second half action by Lee Keagle. That's a lovely pass by Lai Rohira. He created that space, but there's not much after that Lee Keagle celebration. There was a moment that it could be well chased by Navy, but unfortunately Kandy were too strong in the second half. It's all due to the decision making error, especially in the first half, where Navy in the fifth minute of that Nivanka Prasad decision making went breaking. As a result, Kandy scored that try, and then like we discussed, Richard Dharmapala was absolutely brilliant today. He's from a different planet today.
He is from a different planet, that's right. Here we see more of the highlights, but as you watch the highlights, viewers, just watch the contact and how Kandy win every single contact they go into. They won the contact, they won the set pieces, their line-out was supreme. The scrum, they had the advantage over the Navy forward pack in the scrum, at scrum time. The backs, they seem to be running onto the ball more often. There's the try right at the end, or the second to last try, when it could have been done much more easily. A draw and pass. Young viewers, if you're watching that, that's the way not to do it. That's the way how you do it. Delangina showing you that you just draw and pass, easy transfer of the ball, the player on the outside will have the ball. Here's the last try there for Andre. Just to make sure that it gets a little bit more excitement into the crowd. You can see the crowd in the background starting to stand up, everyone's starting to clap. Underneath me, where I was commentating, there was a roar from the crowd and you could hear people almost standing up. I thought the noise was going to come straight through the floor here, but the crowd really got their money's worth today. I think 50 points against Navy, first time that's ever happened. There you can see the crowd and you see the players. They all come in together there. It's great camaraderie and that's exactly what rugby's all about there. They play a good, hard, physical game during the match. As soon as the game's over, they come together. Maybe they might even have a beer together. Who knows?
Absolutely, absolutely. There you go. The Kandy supporters. Most of the Kandy players have said soon after the game, the most difficult part is managing their spectators because they come and mob at you. There you go. The breakdown and the stats. 6 tries, 4 conversions, 4 penalties was the story for Kandy Sports Club. They secured their bonus point. Navy Sports Club missing out on that bonus point. 3 tries, 2 conversions and 1 penalty. And our player of the match, Richard Dharmapala, he scored 1 try and had a hand in almost three other tries as well, Paul.
That's right. He was a special. Well, he was the special player today. I've also got to mention though that the young referee that came all the way from Australia, I think he had a great match as well. He let the game flow. He also stepped in when he needed to. He did give two yellow cards, though both for high tackles, and we believe that that's what is going to happen now that the new rulings have come down from World Rugby. But he let the game flow. He let advantage go. He spoke well with the players, let everyone know what was happening. So hats off to him. He did well.
Indeed, he can't ask a better place than in Netawala ground, especially when rugby is so. Also, his communication to the players was also good, like you said, Paul. So hopefully he had a good game, also the players. But Navy would be absolutely disappointed with this performance, especially at least they could have scored one more try, which gives a bonus points for scoring four tries. But it's still it's not impossible for Navy or Havelocks because Candy have to come through Colombo another two times, I think. Yeah,
absolutely, Sabir. Adding on to what you said, what was crucial for Candy's chances of being alive in this title race was that they managed to get two losing bonus points against Navy. They lost within 7 points and they managed to score four tries, which Navy failed to do in this aspect. So they will be kicking themselves for that. It's going to be a very, very sad 4.5 hour journey for the Sailors. But as for the Candy crowd and the Candy players, it's going to be a jubilant afternoon. They put in a very good performance and it has been an absolutely great performance today, Paul.
Yeah, that's right. It was championship rugby there. Now, we're all so excited. Navy were coming up here. We're excited. It was going to be such a close match. It was a real blowout in the end, wasn't it? It was 28 points was the difference. But Candy, they really showed their championship credentials here today. They were so dominant in all phases of the match. Every physical aspect that was asked of them, they answered in the positive. The set piece was superb. Their line-out was amazing, I thought. The way they set up their driving maul, but also the way that they nullified Navy's driving maul as well. As soon as Navy tried to set up a driving maul, was taking the ground straight away before the maul was formed. So I thought they were really well prepared, Candy. And maybe that little drill they did after they got introduced and just before kickoff, maybe that's what they needed. That worked.
Absolutely. So that's the story. 50 points to 22. Candy Sports Club get the better of Sailors and they keep their home ground unbeaten tag on. And that's it from us from Netawala. Do join us on www.thepapare.com, Sri Lanka's number one sports hub for all your sporting needs, as we will be bringing you all sports updates all around. And with that, Paul Toya, Sabir Carter and myself, along with our production and the technical crew, we are signing off from Netawala. Until next time.